Two red jacks and a ginger lady, double cream, don't be shy.
I see a cam, J and Q on your
face. You bastard. That's me out again.
Hey, Billy. What that lovely water for us, huh?
Lovely, cool spring water, eh?
Yeah. Best money can buy. Hey, Barry, what news from the real world?
You see my brother?
Pick up, Lane.
Oh, got any sugar, mate?
It's weird that you go there. Is it far for the set? Thinking about it.
Sergeant Major's compliments. Well done, our Billy.
So,
come on,
when's fun and games?
I ain't got a clue. But like sardines in reserve. Still waiting, you say.
Amazing stuff, Ed. I mean, I've never seen the like. You know, men and women.
What? Actually fucking...
Actually fucking going at it, you lying bastard. You lying bastard.
No, I'm telling you.
I mean, they was really doing it. You know, you could see everything.
You were flogging this stuff?
Tim Bob a photo.
You mean that a man and woman actually allowed themselves to be photographed while they were...
No, they would do that, you lying bastard.
You'd do it, wouldn't you? If someone paid you £100, do it with Prozzy.
See?
I couldn't be recognised. I'd have to have my face covered.
She'd pay you to have your face covered.
I'll have you, bastard!
Sorry, Sarge.
You be careful, Dennis.
Yes, Sarge.
Hello, boys.
Yes, Sarge.
So, did you buy any then?
No, it was too expensive, but, I did get some others.
Well, let's see them then. Hey, let's see them, you lying bugger.
It's gonna cost you penny each. And I want your fucking money as well.
I'll play for you, Billy.
It's a bit of money.
What are your fingers?
I want my money back, Dale. I'm no good. Mate.
Well, let's have a look.
Now, be careful with these.
That's it over.
Jesus. What? Oh, she's a nice one.
Look at her. Pass it over, McFarlane.
Not bad, don't believe him.
Oh, Jesus. Let's have all the judge.
Ed.
What's the dog cost?
Eddie. Look at that.
Can you get me something? She's amazing.
She's a dead ringer, don't you think?
Very pretty. For a tart.
No, is she like... Think.
If I knew someone like that, my son.
That girl! That young one who came for working post office last year, what's her name?
Swear it, Rob. Don't be daft.
No. Obviously isn't, but. Looks like her.
Hand it over.
Or her name.
I don't know. Time's up, sunshine.
Watch out, officer coming.
Look lively, boys. No, very good. That is. Then the sub is off. Carry on. Sergeant, can I have a word? spend. For a day or two, I think. And we're to stay here.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, what about the rest of the battalion? Reserve, and we're to hold the line until they come back up. That's just before the attack.
Another 2 nights?
But, yes, perhaps, yes. But we won't be going over with the first wave. With third wave.
Yeah, but more nights, these lads won't last
enough. Which was my point, exactly, which I made. Forcefully. But, they say we'll get well-rationed hot food here, so. What do you think?
Third wave, you said?
Yes. We'll be carrying supplies.
Good.
Good.
Clear that mess up.
What's that, Sarge?
That fucking mess.
Digging when I left the fucking mine.
Where are you gonna piss and shit then?
Bloody animal.
Digging shit houses. What a way to fight a war.
Right, why there? Wind your backs. Get out of the way.
Help.
No engineers.
Geese at hand. You're the professionals.
Very good. Fine Barney and man, huh?
Shot of the earth.
Didn't want to throw up either, did they?
Farland, Devonshire, get up.
Get some kit.
Oh, thank you, Sarge.
One up, one down. Turn about.
Sir, seem worse. It's nice and dry anyway.
I'll have a sandwich, please, Ben. Anything you like, anything you want, except for, so that bully beef.
Can we light up, sir? Hey, I've got some pilchards here. Can we light up?
Thank you.
McFarlane. Keep your head down. Right, you two. Listen. No smoking. No sleeping.
Sarge? How far off are they, like? Because I can't see anything from up there.
About 400 yard. But they'll be watching you, my friend. Last lot here had 9 picked off.
Picked off?
Snipers. Why do you think they dug these trenches so fucking deep? They'll have a sniper rifle fixed on that loophole. Every time they see it move, they'll just loose off a shot. Listening's more important. So don't play silly buggers.
All right, Sarge.
You've got jocks to the left of you. Mix to the right. That's all you need to know for now.
Sarge? When's attack like?
I'll let you know in plenty of time. Billy.
Darren.
Couldn't be better. I can't think of anywhere else I'd rather be. How are you doing? Do you want me to take over? I need a piss. So? What's your problem?
I don't know what to do here.
Doing the trench, no one notice. I promise I won't tell.
Oh, you're all right. I think I'll hold on.
Very noble of you.
How long is it since your Tommy was killed?
December 1914.
All right, I remember now. God, nearly 2 years already.
10 days before Christmas.
How did he actually cop it? It's a matter of interest.
It was a shell. Exploded right on top of him. His mate came to see us, you know. To see her mum. I was talking to him afterwards and he said Tom had completely disappeared. Gone. Completely.
Almost completely.
All they could find of him, all the bits and pieces,
fitted in a sock.
Bloody hell.
That's why I'm going to kill as many Germans as I possibly can. Let me go over. As many as I possibly can. For Tom.
Did they bury that sock?
What sock?
A sock they collected the bits and pieces of your Tommy in.
Well, I don't know. I suppose so.
In a full-size grave?
Well, I don't know. Why?
Bit of a waste of effort.
Explosions.
Don't be daft.
That's a bombardment that's been going on for 5 days now. Thousands and thousands of shells dropping on the German trenches.
So?
So, if you were a German, with all those shells dropping on you, would you get out of your trench, go wandering around no man's land?
Right, get some sleep, McFarlane. Stand to at 6.
Right, Sarge. Enough of report, Sarge.
Rob, quiet, right.
I'll see you later, Daventry.
Aye. See you later.
All right, mate.
Sergeant, keep out the night chill.
Teetotal. Taking the pledge.
It's fine. Very good. Very admirable. Brave man, Sergeant Denner, how you do it?
Don't condemn.
Don't judge others or take a drink. It's just... it's not for me. And I like the old tipple. Wee small hours. Keeps me sane. I'm one man's meat. Sorry. One man's meat. It's another man's poison. Yeah. Absolutely. Well, I'm gonna keep down. Are you, I'll take one last walk through and get back to reserve. Long day tomorrow, so make sure we keep the men busy. Don't let them idle. I'll make sure, sir. Well, good night.
Eddie,
what time is it?
Too fucking early to be woke up, for God's sake, bro.
Sorry.
And that girl? The one who came for Wicked Post Office? Did you ever talk to her?
Once or twice. Come on, Bill, I'm knackered. How old was she?
I don't know, 19, 20.
Is she older than us then?
Oh, brain's still working well, kid.
No, I mean, she weren't married or anything, was she?
Good night.
Where was she from?
Jesus, Liverpool, I think. She was an Irish girl from Liverpool, that's all I heard. No, put a fucking sock in it.
An Irish girl from Liverpool?
About 19 year old.
Billy. You don't. I mean, you're glad you joined up, aren't you?
Of course I am. You're daft.
Because I was thinking that maybe I sort of made you do it.
No, Ed. Couldn't have stopped her arm, could I?
You could have.
You're not of age, you could have stopped a woman over here.
Not where you are here, mate.
Oh, God. Honestly, I wouldn't have missed it. Not for the world.
I ain't scared.
Night, Ed.
Stand to. Come on now, stand to. Stand to. Wakey, wakey. Come on there. Come on, wake up.
Oh, sorry.
Stand to. Stand to, you daddy. Belly blasted. Stand to.
McFarlane. Explain. Why? Why?
Stand 2 minutes. Just in case the attack.
Yeah, but we're going to attack them. Tomorrow. Or the day after. They know that. Why would they attack us when...
Oi, you lot! Shut it down there!
Men are improperly dressed, Sergeant.
Yes, sir. What's he waiting for?
Pinnock.
The old clear. Once we've got that, it's Bracky.
Go on, have a look, McFarlane. Tell us what you see.
Don't be daft.
Stand down.
Go on, have a look, McFarlane. Don't you want to know what the German lines look like? Go on, Eddie. Just a quick look, Ed, yeah? I tell you what, I'll give you 2 bob.
Well, you look if you want to.
I would, but it's right in front of you, mate.
Two bob, mind. No tick.
2 bob's yours, Ed. It's yours. Tell us what it looks like.
Nothing much. It's like a grassy hill. See a bit of earth at top. Bit of there wire.
Is that all?
It's like a hill going up to the lip of a quarry. Far off, like. A quarter of a mile. Grass is blowing. Sort of calm. Like a sloping meadow. Sloping up. It's gentle.
That ain't worth 2 bob, sunshine.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
Fucking listen to me!
You was fucking lucky.
Fucking listen to me!
What did you say?
Think about it, Billy. Listen. Didn't listen.
You was
to
lucky.
Me.
Is this your bright idea, Corporal? I don't know what happened, Sarge. He heard the all clear. He looked out the loophole and then bang. You got a cut there. It's a little present for McFarlane.
I think Eddie will be all right. Looks worse than it was.
Don't forget young Dale. Here's got a head wound too.
Oh, I'm sure he saw a little drop of blood and all. Bloody scarred for life.
Oh. Yeah, Dale. Was it a molar or an incisor?
Tell your grandchildren.
I was wounded by a flying tooth at the big booth.
Let you fuck off, fuck shit. You filthy pictures, Dale. Brought us all bad luck. Did you piss off back to Sunday school, eh?
Yeah, Dale, your dirty pictures. They put a curse on us. Shouldn't have brought them up to the line.
Yeah, you shouldn't have brought them up to the line.
Bloody not to the front. God knows what the rest of you have got in your kit.
Yeah, your business, eh?
Just smutty pictures, that's all. Jesus. It's a little bit of fun. You bunch of fucking idiots.
I've never smoked before, but I think now's about the time to stop.
You can't let all standards go by the board. Can we, McFarlane?
Do you want any tea, McFarlane? Sorry about your brother. Think about it though, it could be a stroke of luck. Nice blighty.
What?
You know, get home, rest up a few months. Well, out of this scrap.
He doesn't want a blighty, Dennis.
Be sick to miss it.
He was a nice bloke. Easy going. Not like some of the others, but...
He's not dead, Dennis.
I know. I know, sorry. But he asked me to keep an eye out for you. If anything happened to him.
When did he ever speak to you?
He did. Told me how he got you to sign up.
You listen. I've left school, Dennis. I've got a job. I'm 18. All right.
If you ever need a chat,
mate, bugger off, you poxy little...
And now you're upset. No hard feelings.
How old you say you were?
What, oof? Who took it? Who fucking took it? One of you bastards has been in my kids. Who fucking took it, eh?
What are you talking about, you fucking bump up?
I had 6 votes in here, now there's 5. One of you arsehole bastards that's been in my kit. Who fucking took it, eh?
Oh, damn. Oh, that must be like to a lot of here, boy.
Aye, she didn't like you. She's buggered off home.
It was you, wasn't it, you big fat bumpkin?
Hey, watch her lip piss face.
I saw you looking at him, staring at him.
Couldn't believe your big fat eyes, could you? You've never seen the like. Innocent big eyes staring at a few titties. Fucking wallop you, Del! I don't need your filthy pictures. I'm engaged. I'm engaged to be married, me.
You've what? You have a fiancé back with?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, who stole my photograph?
Shut it, Del. When were you engaged? Jesus.
Last leave.
Engaged? You? Who to?
Amy. Amy.
For God's sake, Horace, why didn't you tell me?
I was going to, honest. I was just so sudden, like.
Was last leaving all. She was a friend of mine too, you know, for Christ's sake.
Oh, she said she'd write to you.
Oh, bloody fucking marvellous. And you just sitting there.
Yeah, well, this is all very lovely and romantic, but we've still got a fucking faith in this platoon.
Why don't you shut your mind, you dumb girl?
You're telling me to shut up, Devon. So what have you got to hide, eh?
You don't say. Colonel coming through.
Watch out, Wigan.
I get free. Colonel in the trench.
Oi! Smart yourself up, you lot. You're like a bunch of fucking tinkers! Button that off! Dennis! Dennis, clear that fucking mess up!
That's maybe closer.
Yeah. All right, gobshites. Attention!
Sergeant. Sir. That he is, it is. Sergeant, please allow me to speak.
Sir. Go, sir.
Anyone got a light?
What, mate? Now then, faithful. What sort of thing were you after?
Well, sir, if you'd like to go over there.
You could take a step forward, Colonel.
What do you expect me to say?
Ah, sir.
Well, the caption reads, senior officer addresses men on eve of the battle. Morale is high. You could say anything you like, sir. Something uplifting, perhaps. Ready, Jeffrey?
Ready when you are, Harold.
Colonel Villiers?
Men, the battalion's objectives are the enemy lines in front of the village of Montauban. I want to tell you...
Sorry, sir. Could we start again? I knocked my hand. Could we start again, sir?
I don't have to repeat myself, surely.
No, sir. Just start talking whenever you're ready.
Right, would you give me a signal, please?
Jeffrey?
Ready when you are, Harold.
In your own time, Colonel Villiers.
I want to assure you, men, that after the bombardment you have seen, you'll be able to go over the top with a walking stick. And when you get to Montauban, you'll find that the Germans are all dead. Not even a rat will have survived. Shall I continue?
Oh, please, sir.
Now, we will have control of Montauban village by 11 a.m. The field kitchens will be following. I'll be able to provide you all with a hot meal. I want to assure you, men, that success is guaranteed. Casualties are expected to be no more than 10%. And in fact, when you set off over the top, you'll be able to slow paths, light your pipes, your cigarettes, and march all the way to Bapaume before you meet a single live German.
Thumbs up, hats off, big cheer. Thank you, Colonel. That was wonderful. We'll have you in the flickers yet, sir.
Mm. Over my dead body. Yes. Now, you fellows finish with me.
One more thing, sir. Inspection the casualty clearing station.
Fine. Shall we go? Thank you, men. Good luck.
We'll give them hell, sir.
Yes.
Yes, well done. Oh, and look here. I want you lads to win as many medals for the battalion as possible.
That's right, Theo, you won't be there.
No, I won't be. But you know, will.
Stand up!
Thank you, Sergeant. Sir. Carry on, Sergeant. Well done, boys. Evansley, you come with me. Carefully, Daventry.
You don't make one more mistake. Not one. And you never ever say anything like that again. Or I'll break you. I'll fucking break you, Daventry.
What actually happened?
Well, we're marching us over this hill, right? But fuck, about a mile behind the lines, eh? Is that right, Rag?
That's right, Chair. About a mile. You can actually see the drum lines. We're just walking along Sham Lake, next thing.
Bang, out of the blue. Boys start screaming, falling over. Dying.
Jesus wept. And your fucking sound was just whizzing by.
Boys just screaming, running everywhere.
And what was it?
Jerry. Fucker seen us marching over the hill. Put a machine gun at high elevation. Good night.
Over a mile away, that's where we couldn't hear the shots.
Fuck me.
What'd you do?
Me and Rag here just ran like hell, isn't that right?
You were lucky. A lot of boys got it that day. Fucking lot of boys.
We were fucking lucky.
So we it was so sudden. Told you. Oh, come on, George. It was just so sudden, like. We were just there and I was having to go back. A few days left to leave. We just thought. Well, half our family don't even know yet. You could have told me. I'm your best bloody friend, blurting out like that. How do you think I feel?
When you finished, Hog. Mashing party. Ambrose, Rookwood, go with Hog. And you lot, fuck off.
Hey, Charlie. Why'd you call him Rag?
Because he's a raggedy arse sort of a fella.
And why'd you call him Charlie?
No, why?
Because his name's Charlie.
I'm not happy about this, Horace. Still not happy.
Oh, come on, George. We've been courting for a year.
£2,000. We're playing cards. That stupid game.
That's me winnings, fair and square.
Double our quids when we get back, right?
I'll be a rich man when this war is over, I tell you.
Will you teach me to play?
Dream then. I was in Southport on the prom with a rather charming young lady. In Daventry.
you think, Brian?
Sort of an idea. That it's possible just to meet someone just the one time. And say, like, maybe, I don't know, 2-3 sentences, but not of anything important, like, but still for that to be something special in that sort of thing.
Fascinating question, McFarlane.
You're talking nonsense, gibberish. Spit it out, man. I met someone once, right? I only said a few words, but, you know, I felt something special between us.
Well, the phenomenon, Billy, is known as love at first sight.
Yeah, I know that. But I'm pretty sure we're on both sides, like.
Oh. The young lady reciprocated.
Well, no. No, I just said she felt the same.
And, what was said on this momentous encounter?
Remember exactly. I said to her, I said, could I have a shilling postal order, please, miss?
Right. And what did Juliet say to you?
No, she would call Maria. Maria Corrigan. She said, you know, I think this is right. She said...
Jesus. What was that? Are they firing back? I thought that wasn't allowed.
Firing. Down to battalion reserve. Running up that ration party. Command. Sorry.
To be continued, young Billy.
Come on, hurry up. And you, go relieve Digby.
Okay.
stupid, McFarland! Get off! What is it, lads?
Come on, good God, what is it?
Come on, spread it out! McFarland, I'm fucked!
Good God, what is it, man?
Come here. Billy. Billy.
Billy? What is it? Oh, he's all right. Just shook him off a bit. As I can imagine. Bad business. Bad luck. Well, it all comes down to luck in the end, doesn't it? What do you mean? Well, everything. I chose those three for the ration party. Could have been anybody. Good luck on those who didn't choose. Bad luck on those who did. That's a bit brutal. It makes no sense. I mean, who's to say what good luck's controlling me? Or you, sir? Us? I suppose you ever expected to end up here. I was rather hoping to farm cotton in South Africa, actually. See? There you go. What about you? Doesn't come into it. I'm a professional soldier. Oh, I see. You're right.
Fine, thank you. Fine. Fine.
Do you like fishing, Sergeant? Don't mind a spot of fishing. That's what I miss. My people had a place up in Scotland and there's a lot of fishing there. And miss my fishing. Never been to Scotland. Very bonny place, I'm told. Oh, yes.
You're a married man, Sergeant?
I am, yes. Children? Two girls, one boy.
Excellent. Handsome family. Pretty girls. Lucky man, Sergeant. Lucky man.
Anything I can do for you, sir?
Excuse me.
Seems the Germans have dug a trench just forward. Opposite us, sort of listening post, perhaps. Captain's asked that we send out a patrol to investigate, check the wire, take care of it if it's occupied, that sort of thing. So, patrol. How many men? As few. Or as many as we want. It's something that we will have to deal with tonight before the attack. Thing before, haven't you? Many times.
And Charlie, eh?
We were fucking lucky.
Direct hit, was it?
It was just, a mess. Ray and Charlie, there was nothing left.
Did you see anything of Hoggy?
He was just lying to one side, like.
Upsets me that we didn't get things sorted.
Your impending nuptials.
I know what that means, Daventry.
I'm sure you do.
You think it's funny to see that? You think it's clever?
On the contrary.
Well, it's no fucking funny, Daventry. Hoggy's dead. You're alive.
Aye. But for how fucking long, eh? McFarlane, come here.
Sarky bastard. He's a bit too full of himself, that one.
Poor old George. Have to kill a few more Germans now.
You all right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Your brother's in a base hospital at East Apples. Gonna talk funny for the rest of his life, but he's fine. Be back home soon.
Thanks, Ash. It's good news.
You better get his kit together. Bundle it up. Beckwith! You come with me.
Billy. Were they all in and stop? Little pieces?
I don't want to talk about it anymore, all right? So just fuck off.
Enough, Sarge. Like as the ace of spades, Beckwith. Give me your bombs. When you see mine go off, chucking yours after.
Research, definitely.
And if this gets broken, head for home. Otherwise, you're with me all the way. Right, sir. We'll be off. Good luck. Thank you. Good luck to you.
Sir.
Right, we need a password for coming back in.
How about Shakespeare?
Victor Ludorum.
Post office.
Post office it is. Corporal, put up a flare every 15 minutes. Got it?
Sarge.
Snout.
Sarge.
All right, Beckwith. Let's sort this lot out.
Every 15 minutes, and send up a green flare. Every 15 minutes.
Yes, sir.
He's a bit of a fucking idiot, that Mr. Hart, isn't he?
Don't mind.
Why not?
Yeah, why not?
Well, you were bred that way.
Oh, right.
Oh, I can't see a thing. Come on, somebody put a fucking gun on him!
This is the van's in.
He was wandering about all over the place after winter threw the bombs in. Didn't even know where the fuck he was going. Ran right into us.
There you go. What about the noise? The man screaming?
I couldn't hear fucking anything. I was sort of deaf with the bombs. Maybe it was one of the Huns in the sap. It was Winter who threw the bombs in. I couldn't hear anything after the explosions. Funny thing, when we got close to their lines, I could hear them, like, singing. Like underground in their dugouts.
Singing? Yeah, well, keep your spirits up.
It's fucking murder after 5 days.
Singing? What about the wire?
There's still a fucking lot of wire left.
After this barrage, Jesus, what's going on?
Must be fucking murder in those trenches.
Aye,
look at the state of that one. Shivering like a fucking rabbit or something.
A fucking rat.
Jesus Christ. You fools.
What?
Nothing's working. They're just sitting there, waiting for us.
Wait. Wait!
I'm talking to you. Was you singing? Was you?
Come on, lad.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have a Gasper. Don't worry about him, he's a nasty little tow rag, huh? Go on, I got loads. That's it.
Bullshit. It's good.
English tobacco, mate, best in the world.
Was ist dein Name?
Zimmermann. Dieter. Zimmermann.
Dieter. My name is Colin.
Come on, steady on, Daventry.
Fraternizing with the enemy. Terrible crime, isn't it, Beckwith? He's the lucky one, mate. We're the poor fucking idiots. You wait and see.
What's got into him?
Oh, God knows. He's an odd bugger.
Beckwith, we're taking him down the line. Come on. Oh, run! Go on.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Shut up!
Fucking shut up. Thank you.
Billy.
Sarge.
What are you doing?
Just going on the train, Sarge.
Try and get some sleep, eh?
Trying. This can't stop. My mind's... I just can't stop thinking.
Yeah. Yeah. Know what you mean. Do you want some jam? Your wife made it. I was trying to finish it off, but there's a bit too much. Strawberry from the old garden. It's delicious.
Nah, thanks, Sarge. Thanks all the same, mate.
Yeah, go on. Best jam in the world, my wife's jam. Whole strawberries. Help yourself, I'm stuffed.
Don't like them, Sarge.
Don't be daft. Everyone likes strawberries.
No, I don't. The little pit things get stuck in your teeth, don't they?
He's got my phone in it, I know he has.
Why did you fucking lie, you
fucking man? Calm down, what's going on? Get off me, get off me! He was stealing from our Eddie's bike!
Right, listen to me, right? He's got me, his brother's got my fucking photo in there, I'm telling you now.
Right. Search all you want, but don't apologize to me. Apologize to Eddie.
Fucking
yeah.
Man,
go, yeah. Fucking kill you. Go on, fuck off, yeah, go on. I'm all right. Just having a look, that's all, boys. No, I'm in that, is here, hey? Hey?
Prick down. You fucking prick.
What? Go on, fuck off then, a lot of you. I don't fucking need you.
Thank you.
watch out there. Wakey, wakey, Beckwith. Doesn't shine. Shine, don't you? Where is he?
It's back in reserve. Company orders.
Make sure that gets off when you're born.
Hey, I'm going over with you lot.
What? Why?
Well, I think Mr. Hart would like it.
What have you told him?
No, it'd be a surprise. I'll make him a couple of German lines, eh?
Alright, fine.
Looks like it could be a lovely day.
Well, you know, in any other circumstances.
But that's broad daylight.
Nothing to do with the tiling of the barrage. Been the same for the past 6 days. Can't change it.
Can we get this food out of here, please?
Right, sir. Right away, sir.
Change of order. Sort of cock up, really, actually. So, if the two companies managed to get lost in the night, so wrong communication trench. Ridiculous. So we're short-handed, and the platoon's going over with the rest of the company. First wave.
That's not good. Not with this lot.
There is nothing. Nothing we can do. There's been a change in the order. And the men will have to...
Yes, this is one other thing. Captain Furnival has given each platoon a football. The first platoon to kick it into German lines gets a barrel of beer. Captain Furnival thought it would be good for morale. A bit of fun, he said. Smart idea. This lot ready by 7 then. Need that rum now, sir.
Yes, of course. What do you see to it, Sergeant?
What the fuck was that? Where the fuck did that come from?
Jesus Christ! Jesus! It was an accident, Sarge. I was propping my gun against the wall and it fell out. Oh, it was an accident, Sarge. Get off!
You're a dead man now, Carl Morris. Make sure you inquire, lads.
Can't believe you do that.
He's not a bad soul. All the same, these types. They're full of piss and vinegar till it comes to the crunch.
It's got to be a court martial.
Firing squad. There's no two ways about it.
Do you think you knew something? Why would he do a thing like that?
Let me tell you what, Bone Miles, son. Because he ain't a red-blooded hero like me and you, mate, that's why.
Dell! Get down company stores, draw the rum ration. Quick as you like, Bone will tell you where it is. What, now, Sarge? Corporal, I want you back here in 15 minutes. Double! Beckwith, got a little present for you.
Hey, bully!
That bottle of beer's as good as one, pal.
You're going soon.
No, I've got to get through it, mate. I've got the bum rest, yeah?
There's all battalion between me and you, mate.
Thank you.
scale the right directions.
You can miss it, Sarge. Or even in the dark, you can't miss it.
Shit it. Mr. Hart, how much whiskey has he got?
No, Sarge.
How much fucking whiskey has he got?
Two bottles, Sarge. Two and a bit.
To use your whiskey, sir.
What are you talking about? Certainly not.
Oh, for fuck's sake. These men cannot go over without rum. Well, give them all a tot of your whiskey. Dutch courage. They'll not go 5 yards without it.
Sergeant.
Permission to use your whiskey, sir. I will send Bone back to get it.
Out of the question. Permission refused. I said no.
You know it works. Offer it.
I warn you.
With the lieutenant's compliments.
I warn you.
They'll follow you anywhere. To hell and back.
Any other time, I would have you arrested and charged.
You've been over before, haven't you? Yes.
So what's it like?
You don't want to think about it. Keep your mind on the job.
No, I mean, is it scary?
Yes, it is. You don't have time to be frightened for long. It's too strange. When you go over the top, you're in another world. It's a place where nothing.
Lieutenant's compliments.
Lieutenant's compliments.
Thanks very much, sir. What's about the guys?
Thanks, boy. Lieutenant's compliments.
Cheers, sir.
Been for you, Sergeant, not even on a day like today.
No.
Thank you, sir.
That's a lot, sir.
Good. You can get back to reserve.
No. I'm coming with you, sir. How are you going to get your tea otherwise, eh, sir?
Fine. Good, good. Thank you.
Fucking way, Oys. Oys. I can't do it. I can't go. But you're gonna go out right with me, Vic. Come on.
I'm up first, you're right behind me, McFarlane.
Sergeant.
You're right?
Yeah. Yeah, I feel good. But I'm ready for anyone. Good and ready.
That's the spirit. Sweetheart.
She's called Maria. She works in post office.
now, Sarge?
We wait.
Hey, Sarge.
What?
One thing's worrying me, Sarge.
Wife?
Something should happen. Might happen to me. Might even. Got set aside just on my mind. It's bothering me.
You'll get through. Don't worry, son. I can always tell. I know the type that gets through. And you're...
Okay.